I paused the game here for quite some time. Started thinking about it. The only thing I can think of. When Geralt inspected the body at the catacomb, there was something that said without proper tools.
A calm day, but tomorrow.
Without proper tools, it cannot be done. Or something like that. Proper tools. It was the only thing that didn't happen there. So that actually makes this even, because I could just go and kill the succubus, but since there is this last phase finding proof, it makes this kind of that I want to do it this way. Alright, and I need to decide what kind of armor I go for. Wait a moment. I remember this guy had a diagram for some really powerful armor. No, it doesn't. Or was it? Was it the smith? Does this inventory change and reset? Oh, son of a bitch! Well, at least you don't have anything. Any tools.
Don't try anything.
What did you sell? Formula. Diagram. Quest item. Are you kidding me? Fuck this. Ah! Now there are all kinds of books here as well. How to kill a bulwar. How was I supposed to know you were selling all these things? Oh, Felicia, Felicia, Felicia.
Take care, what's up?
Now I need to go back. Back to that, back to those catacombs, all the way down below, and where that one corpse was.
And you, my love. Do you trust the girl?
Use the surgical tools to get whatever thing is there. And I assume with that, that'll also be the proof that Ele'yas actually did it. And that the succubus, there's something about Ele'yas there. Save. No bounty hunters here this time. Yeah, this This was probably the only quest that made me kind of wander around and not know what to do. That Baltimore quest was utter, but that was in one way simpler. There are knickers there. Was it in here, the catacombs? Am I in the right way, right direction? Yes. Yeah, this was the only one. There were several in The Witcher 1. I remember running in the swamp forest so much that it annoyed me. But this one. Geralt, don't get hit in the back! Yeah, I didn't make you watch the whole thing, because I needed to.
This corpse
needed
is
to think about it.
Someone
a bit,
brought it here recently.
And it took me good 15 minutes to remember that there was something here that I couldn't get. I think it was this one, turning over.
Fingernail marks all over his back. At least he had some fun before he died.
No, that wasn't it.
These wounds, they're ripped open. Whatever attacked him was ferocious. Interesting. The head's in far better condition than the rest of the body. Dark rings around the eyes, like an anemic.
Ah, right.
Just a few delicate bites on his neck.
No. Was it the hair?
He's grasping a few long hairs in his hand. The forearms are cut.
Ah, right.
Badly,
there it was. In the
himself.
Arm.
There's something embedded in the bone.
That's one I couldn't get.
A metal splinter. Interesting.
Haha. Yes, indeed. Why would a... Why would a metal splinter be there if the Succubus did the killing? Oh, Geralt. I think your dick was right for once. Yes, indeed. Now I'm sure of it. Now I don't even feel bad for Ele'yas. Well, it was good that the game forced me to get the proof. What will happen then? But now that's also an interesting how. Well, I guess I could have spotted the surgical tools in Felicia's inventory without even knowing about the quest. Just spotting the fact that there is a quest item there, and then when I was examining the body, I just accepted the fact that I can't get that without surgical tools. Without proper tools. And then if I'd taken that like that, okay, I need the tools, then I might have gone looking for the tools. I don't know, it's a tricky one. CSI Vergen. Okay, Yerbeth, now I have the proof. After a whole lot of brow. Oh, please, I'm trying to do an introduction to a video here. After much trouble, I finally found enough proof to prove that Ele'yas had murdered all those young men because he was jealous. Jealous after falling in love with the Succubus, or at least that's how I take it now after finding that metal splinter in the body.
Greetings, Gwynblade.
So, now I have the proof, Yerbet.
Your Scoia'tael, Ele'yas, is murdering people from Vergen.
Any proof? Ele'yas is one of my best warriors.
I found a splinter from a blade in one of the bodies. Compare it to Ele'yas's weapons.
I'll see to it. Ele'yas must have learned that I know the truth about his madness. He's fled the city.
For battle prepared in their race's just cause. Their aim to avenge and
fled
support
city.
Saskia's laws. And you...
I think Ele'yas is on his way to the burnt village and kill Succubus himself. And if that happens, then the lion is in danger. You better hurry, Witcher. You better hurry. Save.
I'll not be put down like some dog! Fight!
Just a moment. Let's put my better sword in use. Well, okay, after it, with enhancements, my poisoned sword is actually is better than that one. Right. Okay, Ele'yas, let's dance. Swordmaster moves.
I'm pleased you put an end to that fool's torment. You'll be blissfully rewarded. Disrobe and relax.
Oh, he already let Dandelion go. Well, Miss Succubus, sounds good to me.
In the box by the bed, I left you a small gift. Something to remember me by. Goodbye, Witcher.
Geralt is like drunk. Why? Damage against Harpy's Conjurer. Oh, now he's out of the spell. Descends armor. Interestingly, there's a strong box here. Descends armor. Okay, I think I will meditate in the Succubus's lair and get my last points here. Whirlwind. Adrenaline generated through sword blows. Let's get that one. And then what will we get then? Group finishers. So I think I need this one. I will get adrenaline faster. Oh, yes indeed. And I think that's it. Oh, not entirely. What was that armor? Resistance to incineration, reduction of damage from magic. Well, it's a bit better armor. Don't remember did I get any of those from the enhancements. No, I think it's a... I think my Hunter's armor still stands. I do have the Garen's armor. Garen's armor, but now the question is do I... Anyway, did I leave that? Skin armor. No, it only has plus 9. But it has good resistances. Plus 15. Reinforced leather enhancement, amethyst armor, and dwarven enhancements. I have enhanced the hunter's armor. So for armor stat, that descends armor would be better. Idea when that will happen. I guess I could go see Elton one more time about the feathers. that. While wrapping up here with these quests in Vergen.
Yes, you're beautiful, my queen.
I knew this.
My lady, you're a wondrous sight. All in your nest, envy you.
Oh, I so saw this coming when Geralt started asking, do you want these feathers for yourself and all that weird green stuff in the room. Got any other work for me? Oh, man.
I don't need this feather. Please take it. I want you to have this feather. I have no use for it.
No, thank you. Neither do I.
Neither does this collector, you mean?
Yes. Neither does he.
I wonder why he needed a specific number of feathers.
Perhaps to match the number of empty spaces in his feather album.
Don't see how that would matter.
It's immensely important.
Well, I guess I don't know much about collections. Pretty warm for this time of year.
It is colder usually, isn't it?
The mages must be up to something.
Oh yes, they devise with experiments. Always changing the world. They'll botch it one day, and it'll be the end of us, I tell you.
I shudder to even think about it.
Okay, bye-bye. Oh, man. Let's look at the journal of that. Sack full of fluff. The Witcher did as he had decided and showed up on Elton's doorstep once more and unannounced. Please know, dear reader, that I have described the fall of empires and lovers dallying at the feasts of rich men. I have sung of the loud grief of solitary mourners, of the silent joy many at the death of an usurer, and of the general outbreak of mirth that occurred when Archpriest Janos fathered during King Medal's coronation. I am unable, however, to find words to describe what Geralt saw, for these are some things in heaven and on earth of which even the philosophers have never dreamed. Okay, and to finish up with Flickering Heart. Geralt decided to accuse Ele'yas. He presented that little evidence he had gathered to Irveth. The Skoyatal leader wanted to talk to his subordinates, but Ele'yas was far away by then. He had fled. Still uncertain of the elf's guilt, the Witcher went to tell the Succubus everything. Geralt decided that Ele'yas, guilty or not, would sooner or later kill the Succubus. The Witcher's discussion with the elf quickly escalated into a fight. Well, it actually started right away. And Geralt slew the Skoyatal. We will never know if Ele'yas was truly the murderer, yet we think this very likely. Either way, the Witcher decided he deserved some reward and went to see the Succubus about it. I will not describe how the Succubus rewarded Geralt. I leave that to your imagination, dear reader. I will note only that the Witcher seemed more satisfied than he usually was upon receiving a bulging pouch of orange. All in all, the adventure with the she-beast ended well for us. Were there no more murderers in Vergen? That I do not know, for we were soon forced to leave the proud Dwarven town, and alas, I received no more news from there. And with our feathery friend, Oh no, why did I have to look and see that ass? case of the young men being murdered in Bergen and Ele'yas versus Succubus solved. I think we are ready to leave the town. I will check the inn for my to leave my items there that I don't want to keep right now, and then we'll move on. I don't know when I found the ship and the log there, that's the Mystic River quest, and it told me to find a treasure in Lakmuin. How was it worded? A treasure hidden beneath Lakmuin that combined with these materials would produce Bran armor. So that'll say that we will go somewhere where I will have an access to an area of
I'll
Lakmuin.
Say it again. Humans are strange.
This there was lot to do in Bergen for both the main quest and for the side quests, and some of the side quests were a bit longer than in the chapter.
Look,
one, especially
another
as
one.
I
you
as
let
I
one human in and
how can I help?
Immediately didn't find the right way to do them. But then when I did, it's all done. Okay, so that will go. So silver sword, faith. I think harpy will replace. Iron died finally, and I don't think I will wear this one. Or actually I will. So I will take the enhancements. Hardened leather, resistance to bleeding, dwarven enhancement. On the other hand, if I work towards that Vran armor, then will I save this stuff for that? I'm doing okay with Hunter's armor. And I kinda just want to move on from this part of the story already. Elton's trophy. Oh, I got a trophy from him. Vitality. Damage dealt to humans. Damage bonus on signs. Alright, it's a harpy nose. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, I think I am ready to check those out. Let's look at the sword. Will I actually replace it? Irondite has that resistance to incineration. No, is that fire rune? Oh yes, it is. Okay. Bleeding, incineration. Okay, this is obviously a better sword. Irondite, you served me well. You served me very well. So for so many. So many times. Yeah, it's immediately better, and then I think lastly I added a moon rune to Iron Dite, and I kinda like that, so let's make it the same. Yep. And if I'd happen to run into harpies, that would be even better, but even like that, it's great.
I heard human women need only sit astride a man's pants for their bellies.
How can I help you?
let's put Irondites here. I do have quite a lot of stuff here in the storage I could sell and get a whole lot of money if I need to. But I'll see what happens with the main quest. Okay, so. I think what remains to be done is I will go talk to Philippa about with Triss's bandana, and the hunting magic that kind of I just need to finish this matter of life and death because I have it all. Alright, I need to do this, of course. Get the blood. I kinda thought that would be taken care of by Philippa or something. So that'll be in the castle. So I need to go from here.
Pray tell, what compels you to disturb the Prince of Edirne, Witcher?
I have a few questions.
And you believe I should answer them instead of setting my dogs on you?
I think your Royal Highness has enough foes, here, abroad, in Vengerberg.
The intricacies of succession are not something I wish to discuss with an itinerant monster slayer.
Well, I like this guy even less now.
I'm trying to figure out where this fog came from. What exactly happened here 3 years ago?
Hensel's mages committed mass murder. A dark day for the knighthood and all people of honor. But it was honor that allowed us to survive. There was no defeat. No victory. Honor stood against wickedness. Virtue against black magic.
You took part in that battle?
My father stayed in the capital. He was to defend Vengerberg. I took to the field. I wanted to stop Henselt before he crossed the Pontar, but I was too late. So I decided to await him at Vergen. Henselt's army was exhausted. We would have triumphed if not for that heinous act. Henselt had mages with him, and they cast a treacherous spell on the entire battlefield. A fiery rain fell from the heavens. Destructive, murderous embers which brought the battle to an end. I gathered the few survivors and withdrew deep into the country. The soldiers were terrified. But Henselt showed no desire to pursue.
Only a master mage could have cast such a powerful spell, and I suspect he could not have accomplished it alone.
I remember Sabrina Glevesig. Through the flames I saw her observing the carnage from her mount, dressed in a hunting suit. Straight-backed. Dispassionate.
Sabrina. If I remember correctly, she's Henselt's advisor.
Was. Henselt condemned her to death for casting that spell. The Kedwernis roasted in their armor, just the same way the Edirnians did. You know what struck me when all hell broke loose? What I found astonishing and even amusing? Going into battle, we sang our Edirnian songs. They intoned the Kedwerni hymns to Creve. But when fire descended from the sky, our cries of pain were no different. We all wailed as humans. For an instant, the magnitude of the tragedy brought together our two warring nations.
I still have no idea where the spectral fog came from.
I'm afraid I don't know either.
Succession is the topic of choice in about every inn in the country. I don't know for sure, but I think the Hangman of Vengerberg was the last to claim the throne.
My patience has its limits, and at present, only my respect for Lady Saskia restrains my anger. Come to the point, or leave me be.
Don't change the subject, Prince.
So be it. Let us set our differences aside and speak as equals.
Then tell me what you're doing so far away from the capital. Why aren't you in Vengerberg being crowned?
Well, sadly, my position is not strong there. My father emboldened the nobles. The great families have decided in this hour, so critical for the realm, to revolt.
Your title to the throne is indisputable.
Edirne has become a lawless land, ruled by those who wield might, by those whom people follow. I intend to show just how worthy I am of the crown, and thus claim what's mine.
By returning to Vengerberg a hero, there should be no shortage of opportunities here.
I don't like your tone, Witcher.
You might be surprised, Prince, but I have more political experience than I'd like.
The famous Geralt of Rivia, invited to the table by Calanth, Faltust's little favorite. I've heard you've even parleyed with the Emperor of Nilfgaard. Think I'm impressed? Calanth is dead. Meave curses your name when she hears it. Faltus was murdered before your very eyes, and the Emperor, as I heard it, he thought you insignificant.
Are you going somewhere with this?
Indeed. You should know that a king sometimes needs a hired thug to take care of dirtier deeds. If the thug is naive enough, instead of reaching into his purse, the king buys him with virtuous words, the flash of his rings, pledges of friendship. And when, having done his deed, the thug departs, swaggering proudly like a peacock, the king discreetly giggles. Truly, I never thought you could be so pitiful.
Did I piss you off? Not that I did, I need your blood.
Get out!
Oh shit. What did you do, Geralt? Please? Pretty please?
Get out!
Okay. Have you possibly cut yourself while shaving? Oh, I guess I need to go talk to Philippa. There from that place as well. Right. Philippa's house was here. Well, I'm sure there's some way the game will go from here. Even so, that Stennis is now angry.
I'm on my way to the recruiting
angry
station.
At Geralt, I'm sure we'll find some way to get the royal blood and heal Saskia. And I think I will do that and go talk to Philippa in the next video. So thanks for watching and I'll see you on the next one. Take care, bye bye. I didn't say that.